Hello viewers, welcome to Sharing Minds channel. In today's video, we are going to see how to create an executive timeline presentation. This is an easy template which everyone can create it at no cost. It is quick and really an impressive business presentation. So let's see how the slide works before getting into the tutorial. So this is a simple timeline slide with animation. As you walk through the timeline, you can click the cursor to have the animation pop up, and this would be like more impressive. So let's get quickly into how to create this impressive template. So as usual, like create a new slide. Let's have the header. I usually make the header as bold. Go to home and select bold and change the font color of any color you like and which suits the slide. And I want to place this header on the left top corner. Let me remove the content text placeholder so that we'll have more space to create this. As a first step, let's insert a line. Go to insert and then shapes, and select the line. Okay, let's make the line a horizontal line and place it in the center of the slide. Okay, and next step, go to shape and change the color of the line. I want it to be a darker one, so I'm selecting this, and you can change the color as per your wish and increase the weight as 4.5. Let me make it a little bit bigger. Okay. So the next step is to insert the circle. So go to shapes again and select the oval. I want to make it as a small circle, so I'm decreasing the width and height as 0.22. And place it on top of the line. Let's change the style of the circle. Go to shape again, and here you have the styles. I want to change it as a colored outline. Okay, and let's do a copy paste now. Control C and Control V using your keyboard strokes. So here I want to make four line timeline dots here, but you can make as how many as you need. Let's adjust the space so that it looks good. Okay, now I want to change the color of each circle so that it looks different. Let me go to shapes again and change the color for each of the circle. Okay, and now I want to do the multi-select. Click onto one circle, then hold the control key, and then click onto the other circles to make a multi-select, and then go to shape. Here you see the shape outline, go there and increase the weight as 4.5. Now you see you get all the timeline dots here. So the next step is to insert the hexagon shape. Again, go to insert and then shapes and then select the hexagon. Let's reduce the size of the hexagon so that it looks good. And I'm changing the style. Again, go to shape and change the style to match the circle. Let's do a control V and control C and control V of the hexagon. I'm placing the hexagons in the opposite direction so that it looks good and we get the image, I mean the slide, how we saw earlier. This is done. let's change the color of the hexagon to match the circle shape. So it's a simple same step like how we have done for the circle. Go to the shape and select the style. Now again I want to do a multi-select of the hexagon and increase the weight, outline weight, so that it looks thick. Okay, this is done. The next step is, again I want to insert the lines to connect the circle and the hexagon. So this should be a vertical line now. Adjust it so that it fits between the hexagon and the circle, and we have to make it ensure like it's a straight line. Now do a Ctrl V and Ctrl C of the lines. Again, like we want to change the color of the line, do the same steps, like go to shapes and select the style. Use the same color as we used for the hexagon and the circle. Now let's increase the weight of the line by doing the multi-select. Press on to the control and do the multi-select. Go to shapes. Here I want to increase the weight of the line as 2 1/4 point. Okay, this is good now. Next step is like click on to the center of the hexagon. You'll get an edit cursor. So here you can type any text, whichever you need. Or like you can even like have an image placed in between them. Okay, here you see. The text is like bigger, so I'm going to reduce the size, font size. So I'm doing the multi-select again. I'm going to home and reducing the font size to 16. I think we have to reduce much more, lesser. Now you can see, and I want to make it as bold. It fits in the size of the hexagon. So the next step is to insert the text box. Let's insert the text box here. For now, I'm just placing the placeholder. Likewise, you can place the placeholder, or like you can have the appropriate text there. Now I want everything to be middle align, center align. Select the text, go to home, and then make it a middle center alignment and bring it right below the circle. Here I want to do a little bit of bold and the change of the font size so that like it looks appealing. Okay, now you can copy paste the text placeholder. Okay, That's it. Now we are done with the template. Usually, I don't prefer the white background. I used to have a lighter shade background, but there's no harm having the white background. If you need, you can do this as well. Go to Insert, Shapes, and select the rectangle and make it to the size of the slide. Change the color, like go to Shapes, Fill Color. Here you can see the fill color, and I'm changing it to darker 5%. Now right click it, you get the option Send to Back, and send the rectangle to back. So now you see the other things are coming up. So the final step now is to add the animation. Go to Animation tab. Here you see a lot of animation features are added here. For now, we need the appear feature. So what we are going to do is, I want the text to appear as and when I speak about each timeline. So I click on to the first text placeholder and select appear. You see the first one, the order number appears here. And the second text, I do the same, repeat the same for the other two text as well. So you see the order number 1, 2, 3, 4. On click of the cursor, the mouse, left click, each text appears. So it would be easy for you to talk over the content as you go through the each timeline. Let's see how this slide is working. Go to the slideshow and click on to From Current Slide. So here you see the slide. And as you speak on to number 1, you can click and get the placeholder, and number 2, 3, and 4. Hope you all enjoyed the video. If you have any questions about this template, please do write in the comment section. If you like this video, please do share, comment, and subscribe. Thank you for watching the video.